Hello viewers, today I am going to talk about the topic polycystic ovarian syndrome, which is a commonest abnormality, I can say endocrine disorder, which is seen in 10 to 15% of the population. So before starting the polycystic ovarian disease, I would like to say what is a normal ovary and what is a polycystic ovary. To explain simply in a layman's language, I can explain to you that a thin person can have all the organs a little bit thinner than an obese person whose organs may be a little more thicker or bigger than a slim person. So this is what is happening with a polycystic ovary. In a normal ovary, if I see a small ovary, in a case of polycystic ovary, I can see a big thick ovary. And if I cut open the ovary, I can see some fluid filled spaces inside the ovary. Actually, this is what is mentioned as a cyst in the polycyst, but it is not actually a cyst, but it is an egg which is getting arrested in a particular stage. So when we do a scan for a polycystic ovary, we can see some cyst which is more than 12. If I see like more than 12 in a scan, I can say that this is a polycystic ovary, but it is not a polycystic ovarian syndrome. It is totally different from an ovarian cyst, which is more than 2 cm or more than 5 cm and which can be seen as a single one, whereas in polycystic ovary, we see like multiple cysts, fluid filled cysts. So what are the risk factors for polycystic ovarian disease? First thing comes obesity. The second thing is genetic, and third one is insulin resistance. What do you mean by obesity? I can explain like two types of obesity. One is called android or an apple type of obesity. The second type is a gynecoid or a pear-shaped obesity. The android type of obesity is more important because the fat is deposited on the chest and the abdomen so that you are looking like an apple. The fat in this case is deposited basically inside your tummy, but which is more metabolically active, and it is the one producing male type of hormones in polycystic ovarian disease. And the second thing is genetic. That means if your mother, sister are having symptoms of polycystic ovarian disease, you are at high risk of developing polycystic ovarian disease. The third thing is insulin resistance. This is the same like in diabetes. Your ovary, the insulin production is there, but your body or your ovary is not responding to the insulin, so that the thick ovaries are producing more male type of hormones which are causing the symptoms of hirsutism. How do we diagnose polycystic ovarian disease? Everybody who is having a polycystic ovary need not have polycystic ovarian syndrome. There should be two diagnostic features to diagnose polycystic ovarian syndrome. One, which I told already, the polycystic ovary, or the second one is oligo or anovulation. That means your ovulation is not proper. You are not producing eggs properly. Or the other thing is clinical or the biochemical changes seen due to the increased male type of hormone, which I already told, the LH hormone, luteinizing hormone, or testosterone hormone. How do we detect it clinically? Clinically, we can see that there is hirsutism, that is hair growth over your chin, upper lip, your chest, back of the chest, thighs, etc. And if I do that clinically, I can see that there are increased male type of hormones like luteinizing hormone or follicle or testosterone hormone. So if I see like 2 out of 3, I can diagnose a polycystic ovarian syndrome. If I see a polycystic ovary in a teenage, be careful about classifying them as a polycystic ovarian disease, because most of the symptoms which you see like irregular menstruation, lack of ovulation, hirsutism, etc., acne, etc., are seen in teenage girls. But we have to keep them under observation. what are the long-term consequences of polycystic ovarian disease? The first thing is sleep apnea. That means when you sleep, occasionally we can see that the patient stopping breathing. That is your throat starts relaxing and closing, so that you will have snoring, you will have lack of sleep, and you will have fatigue in the morning due to lack of sleep. The second thing is psychological problem due to your obesity, maybe due to your acne, your hirsutism, your problem of infertility, that means you are not getting pregnant, or maybe because of your irregular menstruation. The next comes diabetes. You are at high risk of developing diabetes mellitus in the later life or as well as in the pregnancy. You are at high risk of developing heart problems, especially when you have other risk factors like smoking, your lack of exercise, your obesity, if you are having high blood pressure, if you are having diabetes, if you are a chronic smoker. So your risk is getting increased if you have all the risk factors. Now you have a high chance of developing high blood pressure, you have a high chance of developing high lipids like cholesterol, triglycerides, you have a high chance of going for infertility, that means inability to become pregnant, and the last thing or not the least thing, you have a high chance of getting cancer of the uterus, that is the body of the uterus, especially due to the estrogen. So what are the symptoms you can have when you have a polycystic ovary? Well, how do we suspect? One, you may have irregular menstruation, you may have inability to conceive, you may have the signs which I explained before like acne or the hair growth, and you can have some black pigmentation over the back of your neck, and sometimes you may have some psychological problems like depression. So now how do we treat the polycystic ovarian disease, or how can you prevent it? The first thing is, again comes the problem of obesity. Try to reduce your weight either by restricting your diet to a low carbohydrate, low fat diet, or go to a nutrition and find out the exact diets what you are looking for. The second thing is regarding exercise, at least 30 to 60 minutes brisk walk every day to reduce your weight. So at least reducing 10% of your weight can reduce up to 30% of your fat, which is the biologically active fat which is deposited inside your tummy, rather than the fat deposited under your skin, around your hip, waist and thighs. Next comes, if you are finding it very difficult to reduce your weight, next comes the tablet called metformin or glucophage. It will reduce your weight, it will increase your sensitivity towards the insulin, so that your response will be better in a case of polycystic ovarian disease. Next comes the irregular cycles. How do we treat the irregular cycles? The irregular cycles mostly are common in younger age group, and we can control their irregular cycles either by giving oral contraceptive tablets, which we are giving for preventing pregnancy, but in this case it is basically to regularize your cycle. And the second thing is, you can give another hormone called progesterone in the second half of your menstrual cycle to regularize your cycle. So you can take it for at least 3 to 6 months to regularize your cycle. Next comes the problem of your acne, hirsutism and all. That is all caused by the increased male type of hormones. The whatever hirsutism or whatever hair growth is already there, you cannot take any medicine to remove that one. So removal of the hair which is already existing is there is only by taking laser or electrolysis or bleaching, or there are some ointments which you can apply over the face to reduce the hair growth. But be careful when you are applying the ointment to avoid sunlight on your face. And there are 2-3 tablets available to reduce your hair growth. But be careful about this one, because whatever hair growth is already there, you cannot do anything about with the tablet. But the new hair growth can be prevented by using these two tablets named as Diane 35. Or the second tablet is called Yasmin, which can be used up to 6 to 9 months to reduce your hair growth. Now, next comes the treatment for the infertility. The infertility treatment cannot be explained fully. You can see your doctor for the treatment of infertility. Basically, the doctors will be giving you some tablets to induce ovulation, that means to produce eggs. You are basically not producing eggs in a proper time. So the tablets are given only to produce the eggs and to help you to become pregnant. If you are not responding with the tablet, then there are other tablets, other injections which can be prescribed by a doctor. Now, the last thing or not the least thing is a cancer endometrium. The cancer endometrium is not very common, but if you are not getting regular menstruation, you have a high risk of developing cancer in your later life than a normal person who is getting a normal menstruation. Why this is happening is because of a hormone called estrogen, which is increasing the thickness of your uterine lining. So what can you do about preventing that one is only by taking, or at least you have to be careful to get your menstruation, to take the tablet and get your menstruation at least once in 3 months, so that the lining of the uterus gets thinned out and your chances of developing cancer of the uterus is low. Thank you very much.